Hello there, everybody. I am the Gentle Brew, and welcome to a weird little game called Dr. Langiscov, the Tiger, and the Terribly Cursed Emerald, a whirlwind heist. Now, as far as I know, this game is really short. It involves a heist, and it's got the guy that does the voice, a lot of the voices for Rick and Morty in it. Other than that, I don't know anything, so we're going to go ahead and do this. Okay, move with WASD and interact with left click. Cool. A house as large as the mansion requires a lot of staff. I doubt the guards know all their names. Hint, loading hint 04. Thanks. Thanks for that. Come on, game. You can load faster. This is made by a lot of the people that worked on the Stanley Parable. So if that's any indication on how good this is, I've got hopes. It's probably got a lot of narration. Oh. Well, that lines up eerily good. Sure. Okay, just waiting for a go from Cairo. And what is this? These tiny things.
They've gone too. Alright, okay, no problem. 1 minute. Break a leg, everybody. Positions, please. Performance 237. Beginning in 3, 2, 1. Let's go.
Tiger. Director's commentary, tape 1. Alright, sorry, if this is like Stanley Parable, there's probably a lot of hidden things I want to find. Letter of resignation. Management, I didn't quit when the flood happened. I didn't quit when you reassigned me to a spectacularly dangerous department with no training. I didn't quit when the forklift broke and dropped a set piece on my ankle. But looking at all those things written down, I'm beginning to realize that I probably should have. I'm not generally in favor of industrial action, but thinking about it when the brand new health and safety department literally catches fire within days of being established, perhaps, just perhaps, something like this is necessary. Santiago Morris, Heavy Goods Transportation, formerly Paint Shop. I guess this place kinda sucks, maybe? We are not being paid half enough. Ignore this. Alright. I guess I'll ignore it by taking it with me. I gotta be on the lookout for those little coins. Damn.
One second, please. Hold your first position. There's somebody at the door. Yeah, I know. Okay, 1 second.
Can we get a precise location on the player, please? There's two of them. Right. Okay.
Hi. So this is a bit awkward. I think it's probably best if we're just really honest with each other. It's a bit awkward. The thing is, the game you've just downloaded, somebody is playing it right now, so you can't play it. I'm really sorry.
Well, shit.
This is quite inconvenient.
You're telling me.
I don't know why this keeps happening. Sorry, we're generally quite organized. You should come inside. I'll explain. Just through here. Oh, no, not that way. The game's live at the moment. I promise you can play in a bit. Promise, but I really could use your help, bro. Come this way. It's perfectly safe.
I don't trust
I mean,
you.
It's mostly. It's quite safe. Just go. Yeah, come inside.
Alright. Fine.
Okay, you can wait there. It's just the green room so much comfier. You know?
C. Parish. You know... Oh, hey. I should probably... There's probably some numbers here. Because those were numbers... And I don't guess I'm going to have a way to
which makes it impossible
check those.
To insert you. And also, it's just quite difficult now for you to leave. But I think it's okay. I'm going to try and call publicity and liaisons, and we should be able to take you to the green room. All right? If you just wait here, we'll be able to get you in. All right, let me just find the number here. Okay. It's ringing. Somebody will pick up. We're okay.
There is no hope.
It's ringing. Don't worry.
This title is too long.
It's still ringing. Come on.
Hello?
They hung up. Okay, I'm gonna try that again. I'm so sorry. Okay, let's see. Sorry, I know we've both got better things to be doing with our lives.
No, my instrument is falling from the event of a fire in around Yosef. Please try and ignore it and continue as though it wasn't there. I'm afraid I'm unable to follow the instructions or continue working this over. I quit. Also, logistics office 17 is on fire. Well then.
Sorry, I'm really sorry about this. It won't be a moment. Okay. Oh, I know what's going on. We've got something of a strike sort of situation emerging. Yeah, we've become quite understaffed. Actually, you wouldn't mind doing me a favor, would you? Come through here. I could really use your help. But if you'd rather wait here, I could just let you know when we're ready for you.
I'm looking for the coins, or whatever those things are.
You know why I miss out on this opportunity, right?
Sorry, pal. I'm looking for secrets.
Very few players get to visit here.
I think you're lying about that part. I mean, but we'll play along.
The thing is, our entire weather department and half the wildlife crew is just up to the left before we could even begin this morning. And it's all super simple. It's mostly buttons. You like buttons, right? And you'll be able to play the game as soon as whoever is in there at the moment is finished. Promise. Your help? Oh, this is fantastic. Okay, this way. Yeah, the lighting department's right through here.
Oh, got a Skype message. Forgot to go offline on that. Hello.
Could we maybe move it along just a little?
You hush.
The plane's been in the loading screen for. Don't worry about the strike. We'll get through it.
Walk. Rest of fair pay, rise to worker safety. Oh no. Dang it! Stop messaging me on the.
You're spoiling some
Skype.
Of the magic, you know. It feels a bit like cheating, but, you know, it's okay. You carry on. You do whatever you need to do.
Ooh. Now these are hidden. Why do I get the distinct feeling that they're just not going to do anything?
Ah, no, that's miscellaneous interactions. We don't need to go in there.
Okay.
Could you get off the table? We've got a lot to be getting on with. It's not a very stable table. Please get off. Come on, get off the table, please. Because it's dirty as well. It's very dirty. People eat off that table. Could you maybe not stand on the table? Thank you. Right, yeah? Could you maybe get off the table? It's just there's all sorts of papers and... Look. Why are you on the table?
Why aren't you on a table? Where even are you? Are you not like the speaker? Okay, fine, I'll go off the fucking table.
That was an adventure. Okay, so if you could just head down the stairs there, yeah? We have a job to do. Plenty of other tables for you this way.
Oh, I like this already.
Right, first things first, could you bring up the lights? Thank you so much. You know, we can't have people playing in the dark. Oh my god, that switch literally says unknown, and you thought it'd be a good idea to flick it? Who knows what it does? I don't even know if we should be concerned. I still need you to pull the lighting lever, though. That would be ideal.
It looked like the light switch.
It's the bigger one.
Boop.
Could you, maybe not do that? Please.
I It's a lot of numbers I should probably look at, but, you know, make sure light is to on. Please do not erase. Where's an eraser? Oh. That one?
There it goes. Little lights blinking on in the windows of the mansion, up past the ornamental ponds. Pretty magical, really. Okay, now we need to attack them with a tiger. It's a heist game. The player's playing a big heist. I don't want to spoil it for you, but the tiger's very important. It's in the title. Alright, into wildlife preparation. Just through the door. You don't have to be alarmed. It's not a real jungle. It's just a game. Oh, Christ. Who walks up to a switch marked lasers and thinks this is the one for me? We have staff. Oh, we don't. Okay, we're good. Look, four switch choices aside, we really need to keep going now. I can't let you in there. Sorry, it's very complicated. Health and safety. It's shelves. There's a lot of shelves. But look, we really need to attack the player with the tiger. It's very important.
I want this off. Dang it. Okay, then.
Right, this is all... It's so safe. We'd usually have someone else do this, but they started striking right after one of them got... Well, that's not... I shouldn't have... Just pull the lever unless they introduce the tiger to the level.
You know, against my better judgment...
Tiger lever. Really?
You seem awfully nervous about this tiger lever.
Look, trust me on this one. Tigers, it turns out, just aren't. They're not in love with the idea of boxes. Oh Jesus! Could you please?
In a minute.
Don't do that. Don't do that. You really shouldn't do that. Look, the tiger won't be able to get out of the cage. I don't think. But I mean, I wouldn't bet it. Okay, look, here's what I'll tell you. This tiger alone has eaten at least 7 human hands. Probably more. Almost definitely more.
Then why do you want me to let it out of a cage?
Perfect. That went perfectly. There should be a red button nearby. It'll just let the recovery crews know that the tiger's ready. Oh no, not that door. There's a far more pressing concern in the room, and it's growling. Look, the tiger's inside the level. We need to make sure it doesn't, you know, eat everybody. Could you hit the red button to send the retrieval team?
I mean, can I? Yes. Yes, I can. Will I, however? Different question entirely. And that was not the one that was asked. Unless he said will, and I was not paying attention in the slightest. Probably coins somewhere. And I wish to find them. Are you not waiting for me to press the button? Lights, action, lights. Foothole. A food hole, okay. boop.
Okay, press it again.
Nah.
Could you press it again?
Oh, there's a zoom. Don't know why. Vault door. Is this Fallout? A candelabra. Woo. Alright.
Oh, thank goodness. The recovery crew are on the move. I worried they might have joined the picket or gone to the union or been eaten by a tiger, you know. Okay, I'm trying to work out where you're going to be most useful. I don't think we have anybody left in Capitals, do we?
Oh, we do. Oh, great.
Wow. Can't believe it. I guess weather control then. The door's just over there. doing. You're doing so great. There's really not far to go.
Okay.
Oh, I hate this room. This hasn't been easy, you know. During our second performance, a pipe burst in here and flooded the whole garden level. Player got stuck on the.
This is the same letter from the
summer house.
From the first All right,
room. Okay, the script calls for a storm. Let's make it rain. It's the red valve on the pipe next to the door. Gently. A lot of the story relies on there being a storm. It's a big part of Act 3.
You can hold your horses.
Listen, it's okay. Don't worry about what I told you about the flood. We've had 235 non-fatal performances since then.
Whoa.
All right, let me be totally honest. In two performances, we had mostly underwater surprise moments. But we give everyone armbands now.
Pyrotechnics, I want to go in there. I guess you're not going to let me go in there. Sorry, I'm looking at the floor a lot. I'm looking for these,
No, too much. Okay, we're good.
These coins.
There's a button below the fan that sorts out the thunder and lightning. Could you do the lightning? It's a really nice effect. It's really nice.
Any more miscellaneous valves? Lighting?
Oh. It might be wired up wrong. I'm sorry. That room gets quite damp. Now I think about it, it might have been taken.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, there it is. There it goes.
That actually scared me a little bit.
The building lit up by these big flashes of lightning. It's really imposing. The set's massive. Oh, speaking of, the player has apparently entered the mansion through the orangery and is. They're going to use the lift. This way. Actually, wait, hang on a second. This is really important. Behind this door is the closest the player ever passes backstage. They'll be right behind a wall. And I don't know what the wall's made of, but I do know that it's phenomenally cheap.
Ah.
So, you're going to have to be very quiet, okay? Just down the steps. Yeah, that's good. That's the mansion in there. I didn't want to tell you, but we actually lost the player for a minute earlier. I mean, they're back now. It's fine. We're good. But they completely vanished for a bit. Which, thinking about it, might be a fairly good argument for not pressing the switch marked unknown. In any case, here's what we need to do. The player's going to come down the corridor and call the lift. And once the doors open and they get inside, they're going to press the down button. When that happens, all you have to do is pull the lever on this side. This lift was always supposed to power itself, obviously. This is just a hangover from rehearsals that nobody got round to replacing. Besides, it's fine, it's fine. We've got plenty of time. And actually, no, wait, here he comes. Shh, out, eyes front.
Bye.
Eyes front. Wait for it. Ready? What are they doing? Why haven't they pressed the button? Did they hear us? Don't move. Now. Pull the lever.
Oh, thank God.
No idea what happened there. I think they can't have heard. I hope they didn't hear us. They probably didn't hear us. At least they're on their way now. Actually, they're going to be very busy with the vault. You could start playing in the grounds. We just need to prep some pyrotechnics for the escape sequence, and then you're good to go. There's a lift to the pyro workshop up the stairs.
Give me the thing.
Give Jojo
the thingy. Sir Crouch. Can I?
You're not into lifts. That's okay, I can understand that.
I'm angry.
We really should keep moving. It's not an unpleasant lift. Really. It's a good lift.
Give me the damn thing. Be right back. I'm getting this. Okay, got it. That was really hard to get to. Did I miss anything? Can I press down? Doot. Why is this here if it just says down? Anyways. You know, when our friend stops talking, we gotta move forward to get more puns. No, it's green now. Can. There's one. Some ding-a-ling-ing going on. Yeah. We can keep going.
Oh my god. Are you okay? Do you still have your ankles? Are they in the correct orientation?
I don't have a whole lot of anything
okay,
going
okay?
on down here.
You do?
So.
That's great. Oh god, I'm so sorry about that. This is the weather room, isn't it? Right. Okay, listen. Since we can't reach the lift of Pyro, the only way back into the game is through a department called High Concept Miscellaneous Interactions. I didn't want to have to do this to you. There's usually a lot of training involved. But I'll talk you through it. It'll be fine. We'll be fine. You brace yourself.
I'm gonna die, aren't I?
It's gonna be okay. Welcome to Miscellaneous Interactions. This is the department that controls... Well, it controls a lot of things. Locked and unlocked doors, interior lights, smoke machines, telephone calls, actor cues, laser lights, vault guards,
nope.
Tranquilizer darts.
I'm a vandal.
You know, that kind of thing. But it's all just done with numbers. I don't know why. And usually the operator's got this big, you know, usually they know what they're doing. But I've got a manual here. I think we'll get through it.
I don't trust you with high-grade technical equipment. Honestly, I don't trust a whole... Hey,
coin.
I don't trust a whole lot of things I've been seeing here. But you know what? Should be witty. Should be lots of punny fun. And me scrounging for just little bits of coin. I don't even know if these do anything. But why not
right,
get them?
In order to get started, you're going to want to press the number 4.
The number 4?
Go right ahead, the number 4.
Ding.
It should be on the left-hand side.
This might have been where I do with numbers, but...
You know, the number
4.
Don't worry about that. Don't worry. That's fine. I think that's normal. Yeah. I don't think that light's a bad sign. 5, 7, 2, 1, 2, 1. 3. Ah! Okay, so what we did there, it turns out, was the wrong thing.
Damn.
Could you press 9 and then 4 and then 1? Did we? Oh, I think we restarted it. It's all right. There's a page in the manual about this. Oh, I think you should probably get that. What did you just? That could have been very important.
Obviously not.
It's all right. Okay, I found the right instructions. All right, I need you to press the number 9.
9?
All right. Let's just assume we've got 9 sorted. Right? Okay, 5, 2, 1, 4, 4. Wait, no! Hit start to cancel that. And then a 2. A 6. Just ignore that. That's 5. Right. 7. 2. Left. 1, 4, 2. Oh, Christ, please pick up the phone. Please. And talk to them this time. How is this not making you incredibly anxious? Pick up the phone. Oh, come on. Again? Do you just not know how to use the phone? All right, back to the board. Hit these 4 numbers. 2, 5, 9. Oh, I guess we don't have a phone. Oh. That sound that I might have told you to ignore, it turns out that... That's a very bad alarm, so I'm going to need you to just do a 180 right down the stairs, please, right down. I'd probably go a bit further. Move! You really want to move right now. I'm sorry I didn't know about the alarm, but there's been a lot going on in my life, and you really must move. Come on! Move! Move! Here's good. Great.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, that wasn't too bad. Okay, back, come on, back up the stairs. A bit faster than that, please. Just a bit, you know, just a bit faster. Come on. No, please stick with me. We've really got to fix this.
I'm gonna go down there. Can I go down there? It's still going.
Alright, don't worry. Actually, do worry a bit. Hit 7, 4, then asterisk. Oh. Is there a fire below right now? Is there something on fire?
Oh gosh.
There is, isn't there? I don't think...
I don't want to go down there anymore.
Any of this room is supposed to be on fire. Please don't do what I think you're about to do. Please don't do it. Just pick up the phone and put it to your ear. Like a normal person. Like a normal person who can answer a phone. No! You did. Why is that you couldn't do? Why did you do it anyway? Why? Wait. Hang on. We can still fix this. We can. I need you to find a blue panel marked downpour.
Blue.
Do you see it?
Blue.
It's turned off, right? I found a way to activate the failsafe lever to the left of the on the right of the keypad. Right, not left. Don't do the left. Okay, when the downpour panel lights up, I'm gonna need you to pull it. When it lights up, not before. Any moment now. Now?
Yay!
Did we do it?
Where's that coming from?
The players left.
I don't see sprinklers.
I think we did it. I don't think it's supposed to still be raining, but you know. Hey, come back down the stairs. You're done here. You don't need to spend any more time in this room. You can forget about the whole thing.
But I like this room.
Well, you can try to forget about it. Whatever.
So trying to keep on the lookout for the coinerinos.
This is it. You're done, sister. Thank you so much. You really helped out. We couldn't have made it through without you.
Literally no signs of fire damage either. I'll go in here. Can I pick this broom back up? I guess not. I interact with these trees. Hey, this is the opening. That's neat. Okay. Oh, yes, this room.
Here we are again. So this is how it's going to work. You go in there. Just give me a moment. I will bring the lights up. And Dr. Langscott, the tiger, and the terribly cursed emerald. Enjoy it. Oh, don't tell me you're getting cold feet now. Anything. Trust me, anything on the other side of that door is peanuts compared to what
you just
gone
through. Standing on the table again.
It's great, though. It's really good. Particularly the voice work. Some of the voice work is outstanding. It's really good. I can see BAFTA sniffing all over this.
BAFTA?
It's really good. It'll probably win awards.
Well, let it go.
Thank you so much.
Oh. Got an achievement.
What? Another player? You've got to be kidding me. I can't do this again. Okay, this is really awkward. The fact of the matter is... Wait, hang on. Where are you going? Right, so, look. I need to talk... Okay, that's the lighting room. You need to put... Okay, fine. This is wildlife prep. No, hang on. This is hang on. There's a tiger in there. There's a tiger in there. That's no. Don't pull that. Wait, no. Oh.
Oh God. Sorry, I tapped the box. Oh, that was adorable. That was. I like that. That was really cute. I'm sure I missed some things, though. There were like 5 achievements. Justin Roiland, that's the guy. But there were like 5 achievements, and I only got 1. And I'm sure there has to be something, like, post-game, too. Because I didn't hear Justin Roiland's voice once in there. Crows, crows, crows. Alright. Is there anything in the options? No. Well, anyways, I'm going to jump back in here and try to find something different. And if there is, I'll let you know. I'll do a video and I'll just cut to the different things. Because this tends to have some of those in it, so you don't have to press C to crouch. Oh. Okay, well, we're going to see if there's anything different. Alright. I like that it's like a hint, as though I'm playing the heist. Whoa, this again. Boobadoop. I wonder what these coins were about. Oh, this is new. Hey, tape recorder. Tape player. Director's commentary, tape one.
Check, check, hello? It's on? Hello? Okay. A deer come to me right now about a parrots. A parrots, they are very interesting birds, very colorful birds. They talk. They repeat what they hear. A parrot repeat what he hears. It's a very interesting idea. I take this concept for a game. I make a parrot character. He repeats what he hear from the player. So the player say something, the parrot repeat. It's a great idea for a game. I'm going to go pitch it to Michael. Right now, I'll be right back to tell the result from my pitch to Michael.
This is Justin Roiland.
And Michael said he don't like my idea. He said he don't like a parrot idea. He don't like it. It isn't my strongest idea. Give me a gun. Ow. Son of a bitch. He had taken my heart. Michael had taken my heart.
1 second, please. Hold your first position. There's somebody at the door. Yeah, I know.
Okay, 1 second.
Was that the end of the tape? Okay, I'm going to, I'm going to skip ahead till I find the next one.
Hi.
So, be right back.
Yeah.
Found the second one.
Yeah, we'll be able to get you in.
All right, Planet Auditions.
Let me just find the number here. Okay.
Alright. Alright, state your name.
My name is Terry.
Alright, Terry. So you're playing the role of a giant cucumber. You're being chased by lawn garden people. So go ahead, let me hear what you got.
Okay, here we go. Hey, I'm a giant cucumber, check me out. I'm a giant cucumber.
All right, that's pretty good. Can you do that? Can you be a little scareder? A little scareder, please.
Okay. Oh man, I'm a giant cucumber. I'm so scared. Oh jeez, check me out. I'm a giant cucumber.
All right, that's pretty good. Next. All right. You're playing the part of, you're recording for the part of a giant garden person.
A giant garden person?
A huge cucumber. State your name and go ahead and give me an audition.
My name's Willie. And here we go. I'm a giant garden person. I'm chasing a cucumber. Come on back and get me. Come on and get ya. Here I'm coming to get ya. I'm a giant lawn or garden character. My name's Willie.
All right, that's pretty good. Not bad. We'll let you know. Next. All right. State your name.
Oh, my name's Little Tommy.
All right, Little Tommy. You're going to be auditioning for the part of the giant planet. So you're going to be a whole planet that's in outer space, and you're going to just be getting chased by a bunch of pickles, bunch cucumbers, pickles. All kinds of stuff like that that are real big. So go ahead. Let's hear it.
Okay. Oh, no, I'm a giant planet. Oh, jeez. Check me out. Look at me. I'm a whole planet. I'm getting chased by a bunch of cucumbers and pickles and all that stuff. Oh, no, my name's Little Tommy. I hope I get this part. Really hoping I could get... I really need this money.
Whoa, that was an incredible audition, little guy. All right, well, we'll be in touch. Jenny, you got all this recorded? All right, put this in Michael's office. This is one of Perrier's games. Yeah, Pierre. I'm getting sick of this shit.
here's tape 3. Pencils, concept 1.
The scary pencils. The scary pencils are coming to attack me. The scary pencils are coming to attack me. What do I do? Well, I'd tell you one thing. You've got to run as fast as you can to the hills. You got to take off of your clothes. You got to run in the hills. The scary pencils are coming to attack. That's the scene of this first act of the game. That's the scene of the first act of the game. Why won't anyone take my idea? Is it just a try to make a game over here? Rejection is so hard to take. It hurts me. Oh, the pencils, they attack. You are running for the hills. You take off all of your clothes. It's such an easy concept. It's such an easy game concept. Nobody cares. Nobody cares. They think they know all the best ideas for a game. I know the good ideas for the game. I want to have a pencil attack. You write to the pencils. But they now attack you. You run for the hills.
Yeah?
You head for the hills.
Plenty of other tables for you. They fall over. They could die. See that lever? It sets the sunset off.
Oh. It hurts my heart. There's nobody... believe in me about my serious. I'm a serious. I'm a serious gonna make of this game. Pencils. Oh, the scariest vessel of terror in the world is a pencil. The pencil's tack. You run it for the hell. Why did they do it to me? Why did they do this to me? It's a good idea. It's a good idea. Oh, it's going to be a lost into the voids of the universe. Oh, so upset. I hit the tables. Ow. Ow, I broke my pinky. The creative process. The creative process in her. It tearing me apart! It tearing me apart! It's a week of 25. the pencils, they are a terrorist. They attack. You have to run for the hills. You take off all of your clothes, each clothing item. It represent 1 point of power. You must lose your power points or the pencils will attack. Head up for the hills! So excited!
In the room, and it's growling. There's an actual tiger in this room, an actual tiger. But it's about 4 feet away from you.
Do you see? My ideas are not a good. The appearance of the attack. You will hide for the hills. What is so hard to get? What is so hard to understand? The pincers attack. You run for the hills. You take off all the clothes. You hide in the bush. It is such a simple game. The game design is so simple. It's so... It's so anger. It makes me anger.
Perfectly. Somebody put it that way. You do know that when I say somebody, right, I mean you. I'm not being too subtle.
Hey, it's me, little Timmy. I got the part. I'm hiding pretzels all around the office. I'm gonna put pretzels in all the nooks and crannies of this place. Just kidding. I'm not gonna do that. I don't wanna lose my job. I'm Mike. I'm little Tommy. I got the part as the planet, and I'm gonna be a planet. Hopefully the funding comes through. The financing for the game. They said they can't finance it, but they're gonna try anyways. I'm little Tommy, and I'm the role of the planet. Check me out, I'm gonna be a planet in the game. Oh, Daisy, I'm gonna place pretzels all over this building. Forget about it. Just kidding, I'm not doing that. I don't want to lose my work. What do you think, I'm crazy? I wouldn't put pretzels anywhere. That's a surefire way to get fired from your voice job as a planet. I'm a big old planet. I hear there's a company party tomorrow night. I'm little Tommy, I'm gonna be there. You can bet your bottom dollar on that. I'm gonna go there and I'm gonna really shake it up. I'm gonna shake this place up once and for all by putting pretzels all over every nook and cranny of that building. Just kidding. Who do you think I am, a lunatic? I wouldn't do that. What kind of crazy person wants to get fired that bad? I'm little Tommy. Look at me. I don't know why they don't hurry up with the financing. Still waiting to record. Hoo boy, hoo baby. You gotta get a buckle on it. Get a buckle on it. That's my quote. That's what I tell everybody I know. Get a buckle on it. Get out of here. You know what I mean? Anyways, I don't know why I keep talking into this recorder. It's not like I got better stuff to do. I mean, it's not like I don't have better things to be doing. I got all kinds of stuff I gotta do, such as hide pretzels all around the building. You know what I mean? I'm gonna stuff them in every nook and cranny. Just kidding. What kind of crazy idea came up with that idea? You know what I mean? All right. Well, so over and out. Little Timmy, over and out.
Well, guys, I could only find those tapes. I don't know if I missed any. I looked everywhere I could. There might have been one I missed somewhere. I have no idea. But anyways, there's some more achievements to get, so I obviously missed a couple of things. If you want to try and find them for yourself, this game is free on Steam. Go ahead and check it out. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed watching this neat little game, and I hope you enjoy watching the next video as well. That's what I meant to say. But until then, fare thee well.